So we are driving through the Kensington Market neighborhood in downtown Toronto. It's a district, and it's also a literal market. It's got a little bit of like a bohemian feel to it. So think, you know, you're walking down St. Mark's Place in the East Village, or say the Venice Boardwalk. A lot of weed shops, there's a lot of different restaurants, and the place we're heading to right now is San Cosme Tortas, and tortas are a Mexican sandwich. It's run by this guy named Arturo, who's from Mexico City. He brought his love of tortas in his home city over to Toronto from Mexico.
Well, the torta has always been part of my life, notwithstanding the tacos and the enchiladas and all these amazing cuisine. I love them, I've been eating them all my life, and you know, I got to Toronto 18 years ago, started Mexican food in Milagro 10 years ago, pushing the torta, but you know, enchiladas and somehow the burrito just take over, and then in the last 5-6 years, tacos. Mm-hmm. And everybody just focused on tacos. And then walking down the market, seeing for the lease sign here, you know, I was at Sanagans buying my food, I said, that's a place to sell tortas. Everybody has been disregarding it, I don't know why I haven't pushed it more, so that's how San Cosme came about.
What does the name San Cosme refer to?
San Cosme is a saint. Well, San Cosme is a street in Mexico City, La Riviera de San Cosme, and it's a street that has a lot of amazing food stands where my dad used to take me. Okay. There's a Mercado de San Cosme, which is an amazing food market. And I just have very fond memories of San Cosme in the area, and I relate it to food. And it was just like a very natural way to say, you know, Tortería San Cosme sounds good.
You've got these variations of tortas where a lot of them are named after countries. So you've got a Rusa, which is Russian, you've got a Holandesa, which is Dutch, as they sort of borrow from different ingredients and recipes and traditions from countries all over the world. So the Milanesa, or Milanese, from Milan, Italy, is a sort of regional preparation variant that has become very popular in South America and in Central America due to the influx of Italian immigrants, and they brought that tradition sort of in the tradition of like the Austrian Wiener Schnitzel, of this very thinly pounded meat. It's usually dipped in kind of like a light egg batter and then covered in breadcrumbs and deep fried. Let's just do this Milanesa. This is gonna be grilled onions on top of a really thinly pounded, breaded, and deep fried chicken. It's thin, tenderized. You've got that cheese and bean layer, sort of acrid caramelized onions. It makes for a really nice sandwich. This torta, which is the Del Chavo, this has smoked ham, Oaxacan cheese, it has avocado, tomato, the pickled jalapenos on the side, which honestly make everything better. It's nice to have sort of the refried bean as a condiment. It goes really well with the smokiness of the ham. Arturo said that so many of the ingredients in the sandwich are local to the market, which is kind of a nice thing. The pickled jalapeno is kind of like a reset button. So, you know, you take a bite of this big, sopping, salty, meaty, cheesy sandwich, and then you just get this clean, kind of spicy bite. It just kind of wipes everything away. These tortas are a little more polished, whereas the street tortas, like a little more, kind of like your bad cousin who you go out behind the barn and have a smoke with. If you think back to the torta cubana I ate in the very first LA season, it was just this monstrous, huge, overwhelming, sloppy thing.
It's got queso, it's got ham, it's got avocado, it's got chili, it's got mayonnaise. It's way, way too big, but it's delicious.
You know, we're in a restaurant, and so it's not gonna be quite like on that level. But these are really good.
All right, just had a couple of really good tortas here in San Cosme. I think I've got a little bit of room left for dessert, so I'm gonna head across the street and get a couple of popsicles. Look, they're kissing. So we just had some great food here in Kensington Market in Toronto. I really hope you enjoyed this episode of Dining on a Dime, and if you'd like to watch more, please click here.
It's gonna cause me to sweat. And this already looks so good. I just kinda wanna show you what the inside of this looks like. This is so hot. very spicy.